Hello there, and welcome back to this video series on programming for problem solving using C language. After watching this video, you'll be able to specify what are fundamental data types in C and what they really mean. Let us notice that there are three fundamental data types in C language. These are primary data types. There are secondary or derived data types, which we are going to see later. But int, float, and char are the three fundamental data types in C. And this int can hold only integer values. This float can hold decimal point or real variables. This char can hold character values. Let us briefly see what are these and also see what is their use. They find their use in C because in C language every variable that we use must be specified first at the beginning itself before we use it for the first time itself. We also need to specify what type of values that the variable can hold. And we also need to specify perhaps what is the length, whether it is 1 byte or 2 bytes or 4 bytes or 8 bytes and so on. Okay. With that in mind, let us see, for example, that if we want a particular location in memory to hold only integer values, then first we need to specify a name, an identifier for that memory location. Let us say X is that identifier, one letter X is that identifier. We say that X is the name of that memory location or X is the identifier for that memory location. And then we have to specify that it can hold only integer values. So we use the keyword int in some sense or the other, and then we'll specify the length. So we use something like int X with a semicolon at the end. We use that semicolon at the end because every C statement must have a semicolon at the end. So this statement selects a particular location in memory, gives it a name, and restricts only integer values to it. Now there are 2 bytes allocated for a variable that is declared as int. Okay. 2 bytes means each byte is 8 bits, so 2 into 8 16 bits. So we see that the size n is equal to 16. It can hold minus 2 to the power of 15, 2 plus 2 to the power of 15 minus 1. Int and signed int are the same, whether you put a positive sign in front of it or not, it really doesn't matter. So we can see that there are 4 possible type qualifier. What we mean by a type qualifier is, for example, if you want only positive integers, then we need to say unsigned int. This word unsigned is a qualifier for int. There are 4 type qualifiers for int, and those are short, unsigned, long, and constant. This table here shows all the uses of type qualifiers here. When you use the word short, it indicates size in bytes 1, whether short int or unsigned short int. When you use int, the size in bytes is 2 bytes, whether signed int or unsigned int. When you use long, it is 4 bytes. When you use the additional word constant, then that variable cannot change further in the program. Similarly, for float, we have type qualifiers as shown here, double, long double, and constant. These sizes, there is a way to compute them. We will try to see if there is time for it. Similarly, for character, if it is signed, it is 1 byte. Whether it is unsigned, it is 1 byte, and the sizes are as indicated here. Again, this word constant precludes it from changing value. That is all for now. We will see further applications later. Thank you so much. Have a great day.